a new competition this year. Last year we ran a pilot, 380 clubs got involved. This year over 500 will be involved. It's a development of last year where this year there will be a prize for the winners. They'll be able to go to Barbados for 10 days. 14 of the squad will go there. The regional winners will get some flat wicket covers. The area winners will get some subsistence to ensure that their travelling costs aren't too prohibitive. And over the whole of the competition, clubs will be playing within their leagues, and the winner of the league will represent the league in the future as it moves on from area to regional finals.
What feedback did you have about last year's competition?
It was very successful, and the truth of the matter is more clubs want to be involved in it. It's really just a matter of how we roll it out, how we engage more, how we ensure that the grounds we play on are of a high standard, and the players that play for the club and represent the club in the way that we would want them to, under Premier League rules and Premier League conditions. So it's all orderly with umpires and everything else. And as we begin to bed that down, we'll then be able to roll out the programme and involve more clubs in the future.
The final at a first-class ground, Sky Sports, under the floodlights, fantastic for a club cricketer.
Absolutely. There's nothing better. You know, you play all your time and maybe you've had a taste of being a trialist on a county squad or something like that, but ultimately, if you play your cricket on a Saturday or a Sunday with your club, and you get the opportunity to play at a test match ground, as was proved at Cardiff last year, it inspired everyone. And the product, you know, the one that was shown on Sky was fantastic and a great advert for club cricket. The money that we're asking for, the £50, it'll all be ploughed back in so that the clubs, maybe they do get knocked out in the first round, can still qualify for a grant to help them with a mower or something that they need at their club. And we haven't quite dealt with the fine detail of it, but all the money, the £50 that we're asking for to be part of the competition, will all be ploughed back into the competition through a fund. They'll also get two bottles of Cockspur rum, which they can sell or put in a raffle to raise the money. And one of the great things about it is, by having it as a league competition, it gives the opportunity for the league to value their sponsors and to thank their sponsors for the ones who do get to the final, because the sponsor's name will be on the shirt when they play at the first class ground in the final game. And that's something that we feel that, you know, we can give back.
The 2020 competition is much enjoyed by, I think, both supporter and cricketer. And so we felt that it was right to do this competition. Last year was a bit of a pilot, and to see how it could run and whether people would enjoy it, and I think they did. You talked to any of the clubs that were involved, they really did enjoy it. And of course this year, you know, it's 500, and hopefully next year it might be 1,000, and the year after maybe 1,500. But we just need to see how we could control it to make it a good competition, a competition that everybody enjoyed and was fair. But at the same time trying to get everybody involved, because it is a competition that we feel everybody can compete in. For a club cricketer to play on a test match ground, possibly under lights, must be just a huge impact. I remember what it had on me when I played under lights first time. It was absolutely amazing. And if, you know, somebody from club cricket can do that, that's got to be great for cricket.
And you'd encourage every club to get involved?
Oh, without a doubt. I mean, everybody knows it's a fun game. It gets people down there, people enthusiastic about it. It's a short game. There's lots always going on. And as I say, it's a family game, or it seems to be these days, and one hopes that's what's going to drag some more volunteers down to the clubs, and the clubs always need volunteers, and the clubs always need people coming down to help the club survive.